So you want to set up a group call, maybe a recurring call, just to support your community at this time. I'm going to show you how to do that in Zoom, and I'm going to make it a scheduled call, like a regular recurring meeting. I'm going to show you how to do that right now. To log into Zoom, obviously you need to be a subscriber of Zoom. So I'm going to log in my account here. And then I'm going to go to meetings here on the left and schedule a new meeting. Right. So my meeting is going to be, I'm going to call it Calm and Courage meeting. And then I'm going to chance to catch your breath and work through this one tiny step at a time. Now, really, really important is when are you going to hold these meetings? And I'd really recommend that you do it at the same time. Let's say that there's going to be more than one meeting. I recommend that you do it at the same time. Even if it's a daily meeting at this stage, or maybe one every 3 days or once a week. I'm not sure how often you're going to do it, but I would recommend that you do it at the same time each time. However, if you are working across people in two different time zones, then make the two meetings like 8 hours apart or a long time apart so that you can capture the people in Europe, the people in Australia, in America, wherever. Okay, so I'm going to set this meeting for, well, I could actually set this for today. And I'm going to make the meeting, even though I'm going to make it an hour, I'm actually going to make it an hour 30, because by the time we end up getting on the call and, you know, saying hello to everybody, we're going to end up, you know, especially if you have a question and answer, then it's going to go longer. So I'm going to make that meeting longer, and I'm going to make this my time zone here. So I've set it to 11 a.m. here. I'm just going to do a quick check what time that is. Convert Sydney time to, say, New York. So at the moment, 11, so we're 15 hours ahead in Sydney at the moment. So 11 a.m. Sydney, where's 11 a.m. Sydney? Ends up being 8 p.m. New York time. So that's not a bad time. Okay. I'm going to make this a recurring meeting. And at this point, I'm going to make it, I could make it every day. I'm going to repeat every 2 days. I'm going to make it every day for seven occurrences. We'll just see how things go. I'm going to make it, you do not need to register for the meeting. So pretty much anyone can join, and you don't need a meeting password. Okay, you can just jump in. Now, this one, this bit here is important. I'm going to make it that I'm the host, but I don't know how many people are going to be joining this call, joining this meeting. So I'm the host, so I want my video to be on, but participants, I want their video to be off, because people sometimes get, look, it really just depends on what group that you're meeting with, but you may want, because they may be starting to share their screen, they may be embarrassed, they may be introverts, they may not have, anyway, they, for a lot of reasons, they may not want to be on video. Now, people can also dial in by phone. And so, where from? So I'm going to recommend, instead of just having one country, I'm going to put in a few countries here. So I've got, this is where my audience is, Australia, United States, Canada, Israel. I'm going to add a couple of, I'm going to add one more, which is United Kingdom. Now, all of these others can still dial in, but this is really just for the invitation. It's going to have those phone numbers in, their local phone numbers. So I'm going to quick save there. So that's only for those dialing in rather than people logging on video. Now, these ones here, enable join before host, means that if somebody dials into the meeting and you're a few minutes late yourself, you're the host, or you're having technical problems, they can still be there in the waiting room. They can still be joining the meeting before you do. We can mute them on entry so that when they do jump in, you don't hear any background noise or dogs barking or children or whatever. And then they can unmute themselves as soon as they join the meeting. We can also enable a waiting room where they just get a message. Your host is has not yet started the meeting. And then you could put a little message in the waiting room there saying, look, in the meantime, here's how you find out about the next meeting. Here's an email address. Follow me on Twitter, on LinkedIn, or something like that. Okay. Only authenticated users can join. And do I want to record the meeting? And so actually, I'm going to say record it automatically because I'm going to want to upload that meeting video onto my YouTube. So that's how to do it. There's a lot more I could say, but I'm not going to put that in now. And I'm just going to hit save. And then that has created the meeting. I could now send this off as a copy of the invitation. Okay, you can see all of this. The host's video is on, the participant's video is off. And then when it comes time, I can just start the meeting. Oh, I want to add that to my calendar, but I also want people to add it to their calendar. So that's it. And then when I'm ready at the time, I just click start the meeting. And now notice I've got this only set up for 7 occurrences at this stage. And that's it. Of course, you then want to share it, share your meeting out on social media. Invite people maybe through your email list and basically show some leadership here. Hey, this is how you join. This is how you dive in and you know, I'll offer what support and help I can.